In this video, we use our laser machine to create this sophisticated enclosure with a fan for our Raspberry Pi 4.
I made this Raspberry Pi 4 case from 1/8 inch black acrylic.
Pies!
Just like the previous Pi case I made, these parts will be stacked. This time, I changed the cover's design to use the Raspberry Pi logo and incorporated holes to mount a fan. The acrylic sheet came masked from the factory, so this was left on to keep all the pieces clean during the engraving and cutting process. Before any assembly could happen, the Raspberry Pi needed some heat sinks installed. This was already done in our previous Pi case video, but I thought it should be shown again in case you didn't see that video. But you should. Hint, hint. While the paper mask was still on the parts, it was a good time to add some color to the Raspberry Pi logo. I used regular acrylic paints to fill in the engraving. Green for the leaves and red for the raspberry. It took a few coats of paint to get good coverage. While the paint dried on the cover, all the other case layers had their mask peeled off. I added standoffs to the base. In case you're wondering, screw sizes and stuff, all the parts that were used in this project will be listed in the description below. The bolts that would hold all the layers together were also inserted. Just like for our other Pi case, the bolts were upside down during the assembly, but would be reversed later. The Pi was installed onto the standoffs, then all the layers were stacked together. The cover was peeled, revealing the Raspberry Pi logo in all its glory. I think it came out really good. Before the cover could be bolted to the case, the fan needed to be attached to it and then plugged into the Pi's board. The fan was attached to the cover with very small and annoying to handle nuts and bolts. The fan was oriented with the airflow facing toward the board. The fan's power connectors were plugged into the board's 5-volt pins. This would spin the fan at full power. It's hard to see, but the pins I used in that row are the second and third pins. It looks like I used the first pin, but it's actually hidden behind the connector. Again, just like in our previous video, I had to reverse the bolts if I wanted it to look good. Adding two nuts on opposite corners held everything together so that each bolt could then be reversed and secured. Honestly, I like this black case a lot better than the clear one I previously made. Besides the act of cooling, I just really like the way the painted Raspberry Pi logo pops on the black background.
for watching. Let us know in the comments what you think and if you've ever thought about doing a project like this. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell to get notified of future projects. We have more projects coming soon. Stay tuned.